Mr. Gulabchand, thank you very much for talking to NDTV. All eyes, of course, are on the Bihar election outcome. For India Inc., how significant are the elections outcome in Bihar, and what does it really mean for the government's reform process?
It's immaterial. The outcome is immaterial to what's going to happen.
Okay. And why do you say
that? There's a government in center, which is a full majority government. It is performing. It's going to go all the way in 5 years. So the Bihar election is a state election and has no serious bearing at all on.
But what does it do to the reform process, which has been on a back foot for quite some time in terms of the key bills of the government, GST, land bill? Do you think it's going to have some bit of an impact and the overall sentiment that we have here in India?
I do not believe so. For the simple reason, GST and these land reforms are a necessity for India. We have to create 1 million new jobs every month. With this kind of demand, because this population is born today, these 300 million, they'll come seeking jobs. So we have to create this enormous amount of new jobs. This can't be created only in agriculture. So it has to be created in other than agriculture, which is manufacturing and services. So land acquisition bill becomes important.
Right.
We need to build a huge amount of infrastructure so that these jobs can be created. Don't forget, America, the largest economy in the world, employs only 135 million people. And you want to create 300 million new jobs. Look at the order on hand, it's so tall. So you will need them. So sooner or later, everybody will have to agree. And besides, I'm not so sure that it's already agreed and it'll probably go through. Maybe the Congress may not support it. But the Congress brought this country's economy to a standstill, so that's not a surprise.
What's your view as far as...
The other GST is concerned, I think it'll be done.
Okay.
It's in the interest of everybody. And those who stall it must think whether they would bat for India or not.
What do you have to say about the reform process, the reforms that have been taken so far by the government? How would you look at the performance of the government till now? Have the things also started picking up on the ground? Are you seeing results on the ground as well?
See, let's first understand the extent of the damage done by the previous government's actions and policies and several other judgments that came is enormous.
Right.
It has taken us a good year and a half to find out how bad it was.
Okay.
Now we know that it will not be, it wasn't just 18 months to rectify, it would be at least 2 to 3 years to get back. So we know that situation. Second is, they did launch upon a number of reforms. They've been stalled. They can only be stalled, they can't be stopped.
Right.
Second is, in an Indian system of government, you come into office suddenly. Our parties don't have very clear-cut ideas in each area's field of operation. If you see most first 100-day plans are for a government in second term. So till they comprehend what the job is, what is the extent of the, what is the state of the treasury, what are the issues to be tackled first, if you really see, it takes a while.
Right.
Now this government has spent that 1 year in this, in little more than 1 year into this. There are many great initiatives that have already been done. Removal of central planning. For those of you who don't understand that, you're young, central planning was a Moscow model of the state controlling the resources of the country. So even where you will work or what you will do was determined by the state. That is gone.
Right.
In its place, you got a Niti Aayog, which is about policy, different policy options. An arm that government seriously needs. Then you have many other cases, like the courts cancelled the licenses of so many coal mining, of going back even 23 years. Government reacted with alacrity, or re-auctioned them quickly, and have started the process. These are not something you can buy shares in the morning and afternoon you're owner, by evening you sell them. There's a process in this. And in the meantime, there have been consequences. Those will also have to be taken into account. Then when you look at these things, that the amount of other things they've done in terms of launching the Swachhata Abhiyan, which is so essential for India, for its own health, for its own aesthetic look, for the look at the business it will spawn in terms of keeping this country clean. Not just an idea of an individual, but also as cities and towns keeping themselves clean.
Right.
So you have many such reforms that have happened. Company law was amended. Maybe it's inadequate. They're again doing a second tranche of that. They're putting down the several tax structures into place that will help. So I think they are on the reform mode. They've already reformed their foreign policy, which is most essential for the security of you and me and for this land. So in this context, it is moving steadily. And I think after 1.5 years in office, they have fully comprehended what is going on, and I expect them to take bolder steps as they go along.
What are the top three bold steps you expect from this government that they should take in the next 1 year?
When I government, I mean is the whole body of decision makers, just government.
Reforms which are needed for the sector, for the industry.
For first three, is resolve the monetary crisis of the infrastructure industry and the construction industry.
Right.
Because infrastructure is the first thing you will need. Without which this manufacturing or make in India is a non-starter without that infrastructure. So that is one that they need to do. So you sort that out and you put. Drastically bring down the interest rates, which is very essential. This 0.25, 0.5 on 13% is very little.
Okay. How much do you want?
I want 200 basis points to begin with and going down.
But we've already got 1.25%.
What is 1.25?
When
there are interest rates are too, what are you happy with? You look at what is needed or you go to look at what you're happy with? Because it sounds good. I'm sorry, it is not good enough. When countries which have 2 and 3% interest rates bring down by 0.25, they're bringing down the interest rate by 0.25%. So we are 13% interest rate. What is 25% of that? At least 400 basis points. So we must bring it enough. And there's a logic to it.
Okay.
Today at these interest rates, you need 21% IRR in order to do a project, which is high risk.
So is
very
that
few entrepreneurs will come forth and very few investors will back them. So if you have to bring it down to 14 and below, interest rates have to come down to 7.
So are you trying to say that because interest rates are still high at this point in time?
Also, yes.
That's the one of the reasons why projects are not taking off.
That because there are 2-3 reasons. Even if there are projects, they will have limitations in taking off because of high interest rates. I'm saying both need to happen. Then to kickstart the economy, the government has done the right thing. They've started government expenditure. That is how it will begin. Before private expenditure comes in. So all these things have to be done. And not that they will not happen in some form or the other, but it is important that if for them to be highly effective, so that we can go back to high growth rates, which we need very badly, if you have to employ all these people, and if you have to really create, the most inclusive growth rate is the highest growth rate.
Are you satisfied with the kind of public spending that we have started seeing, especially in the roads, infrastructure
sector? They've started now, so I'm happy with that. Because they were not able to spend. They had no fiscal space to do so. Now they're doing it. They were left with a treasury that had problems. They got a bit lucky with oil prices coming down, commodity prices, though that's a mixed bag because India also produces commodities. They kept sensibly food price increases down to 4%, unlike the previous government which did 15 and 20% every year, which created a huge food inflation. So the inflation has come down for all these reasons. So now only the interest rate stands in the way. How to bring it down, well, that's a matter of economic thinking and how to do it.
But there is a need to bring down.
I'm bringing it down. I'm telling you why Indian industry needs it. It's also under stress, and you're increasing the stress with the high interest rate, which I don't think is necessary.
And what is that third bold step that the government should take at this point, or the policymaker should take?
The third bold steps is they have to take at other laws like company law, some of the tax structure. Then when you talk of ease of doing business, It's across the board. It is not one policy, one reform.
Right.
Can I get my passport easily? Do I get harassed adequately at the airport? Do I have to fill too many forms coming in and going out? Do they, policemen, stop your car because your glass is tinted? You know, is this what we want our police to be doing? Is it relevant?
So would you share...
So there are, from that small things like that, to more important things of starting a new business, yes, that a lot of attention is being paid now, and the states are in a huge race to do that.
Do you think Maggie incident, that entire Nestle incident, has brought in some bit of fear, or probably it's going to dent India's image in some way globally, who are already having an operation here?
Forget about denting India's image. If
but has
I'm
it
going to
some
be
bit
frivolously harassed, like we were closed down in Lavasa for no real reason, except jurisdiction as a last minute idea. Something like, when you see things happen whimsically, things happen without proper testing, then the faith in the system is reduced. So, and I take huge risks. Look at the amount of brand damage that it has done. For what? One third-rate lab which has no bloody credential, made to decide it so. The toughest administration in the world, which is the Food and Drug Administration, USA, it passes. Seven other places it passes. So this is frivolously done. Won't be surprised if there was something behind it. So these fears are the one that, forget foreign, Indian investment will fear that. Maybe India knows to tackle it a bit better.
Yeah, because
but brand values do get hurt. And brand values are very important. Brand is about walking a brand. So you must understand that these are important. Like Maggie.